We've got a family of five, three kids, 7 to 14, so they're really sort of charging up through the ages. So the challenge really, I think, was to design a family house in a suburban location that was really going to work for an evolving family. It works very well to have a series of pavilions where we can all occupy a variety of spaces and a variety of multifunctional spaces, inside and outside, for the whole variety of times of the day and activities and interests of the kids and ourselves. Looking around this neighbourhood, there's a lot of villas. And sort of standing back looking at the site, it seemed to me that there was a great opportunity to try and break the house down into a form and scale that sort of fitted the context of the heritage neighbourhood. So the house is arranged along a long spine corridor, and stepping up through the site, and the three pavilions are sort of plugged into that, and while they're similar from the outside, they have quite different configurations on the inside. So we arrive up the stairs and we arrive into the space we're sitting in now, which we like to refer to as a garden room because it really is an extension of the courtyard. Then that flows across to the lower level of the middle pavilion where the living room is. So there's no room that's bigger than 4 by 6 metres in this house, which is probably quite unusual in a modern house. You know, there's been a sort of a love affair with the open plan. So that's been an intentional thing here to have a larger variety of smaller spaces. But I think at the end of the day, they just might make for quite nice, intimate social spaces. I guess designing a house for yourself is always a challenge, but it has some great opportunities as well, because we can afford, or I can afford as an architect, to just experiment a little bit further and push the boundaries. So as a result of all of that, it's been a really successful house to live in.